Hello guys, Sanjay here, and as you can see, I have View Utopia with me over here, and this is the packaging with which it comes. And at the rear side, we have some specifications like Snapdragon 810 GPU is Adreno 430, clocked at 630 MHz. Oh, that's cool. There was a time when the processor in mobile phones were clocked at 630 MHz. 5.2-inch Quad HD display, 32 GB ROM, that is internal storage, 4 GB of RAM, 21 MP camera, many things like that. Plus CyanogenMod 12.1, which is really amazing. But if you are launching this phone after Marshmallow is released, and after a month that Marshmallow is released, I was hoping that Utopia will come with CyanogenMod 13, but it's not, so let's keep that aside. We have the phone over here, and I'm quite sure that this is Utopia. Okay, let's open it first because I'm more excited about this. It's kind of heavy, I guess, after using MI4C, which is like very lightweight. I'll feel that it is kind of heavy, so yeah, it fits completely in hand. And yeah, it's a very good mirror also if you turn off the display. Let's switch on the phone. Let's keep this aside. And something very important over here, the most powerful phone ever. It has only Snapdragon 810 and 4 GB of RAM. I think that those are the same specs as that of OnePlus 2. I don't know then how come Utopia is the most powerful phone ever. So let's take a look at the device itself, and at the right side we get volume keys and the power button. Power button is placed in the middle, and there is enough distance between volume keys and the power button, so it is easily distinguishable. And this is the same method that was used in Euphoria also. At the rear side we have 21 megapixel camera with a very huge bump and a fingerprint scanner, which according to me worked really fine. At the top we have the 3.5mm headphone jack with DTS support. Basically what it means is that it should give very good sound output, and we'll surely check that. And at the left side we have our SIM tray and a micro SD card slot also. So the device is dual SIM, plus it supports micro SD card also, so that's surely a very good thing. And in the front we have 5.2 inch Quad HD display, which according to me looks, oh my god, it's really awesome. And that 25,000 we are getting that. Oh yeah, I'm very very excited to test out the display part of the phone first. And in the box we get House of Mali earphones also, and I surely hope that they sound amazing with the Utopia. And I'll mention about that in my review also. But if you want to know some things, then do follow me on the Twitter. I'll give the direct link in the description box below. I'll be posting updates about Utopia over there. And in the box we get a quick charger also, or you can call it fast charger or turbo charger or whatever you wanna call it. Basically it supports Qualcomm charging 2.0, so the charger can give output up to 12 volts and 1.25 amperes. It will surely charge Utopia like crazy fast, and that's surely a very good thing to get a quick charger inside the box. And we get a USB cable also, micro USB cable to be precise. And I have too many micro USB cables laying around my house, so I think I may not use this at all. And at the bottom of the phone you will find a microphone. Yeah, that microphone is used when you do calls or when you want to record something. And the speakers are present at the back side of the phone, so no front facing speakers for Utopia. Only one pair of extra tips over here, so yeah, it's not like House of Mali in which you will get multiple tip covers. So that was for the unboxing. Now let's switch to phone, and let me just set up the phone and we'll take a look at the phone after that. So now let's set up the fingerprint scanner that we have at the rear side. So let's select pattern. Okay, so the fingerprint is added. So now let's immediately go into settings. Okay, come on, Snapdragon 810, the most powerful phone in the world. Go into settings now. Okay, So if we go into about phone, it is based on Android version 5.1.1, that is Lollipop, and CyanogenMod OS version is 12.1. So no CyanogenMod 13 as of now, but CyanogenMod 13 should be on its way for the Utopia. So let's assume that they release CyanogenMod 13 as early as possible. Let's see how the fingerprint scanner works. So okay, the phone got unlocked really fast. Okay, this time it didn't. Okay, so it got unlocked now. And now let's talk about some of the CyanogenMod 12.1 features which are present on the Utopia. So let's start with some of the gestures. And if we go into display and lights, double tap to wake is present. So you can just double tap the screen and the device will get unlocked. And some other gestures are like draw a circle to activate camera, flashlight, for that draw V. So if I draw V, then it will turn on the flashlight. If I draw V once again, it will turn off. Draw O to turn on the camera. So here is the camera, and as we are in the camera, let's take a picture and let's see how it is. So the photos look really good, but I'll surely test it out more today only because I'm so excited about this. Let's switch to front facing camera, and front facing camera also looks too good. Oh my god. And this 2K display is also super sharp. And one of the features that Utopia was launched with is Around You. So to go into Around You, you can simply scroll to the left side of the home screen. It will take you to the Around You option. Welcome to world around you. So, and this is a specific app for you phones by you. So, and it's kind of bloatware according to me, because I'm pretty much sure that we cannot uninstall this application. And some of the bloatware that is installed already on the phone is like Gaana, Music by Gaana, and Universe, U Account. All these applications are not necessary for me, but I cannot uninstall them also. If we go into AppDrawer is something like this, which I personally do not like. So to change that, long press on the home screen, scroll up, and change the layout from vertical to paste, and it will go back to the normal app drawer that we see on the phones. And we are using this device for almost 15 minutes now. I edit the videos because I do some mistakes and just fast forward some of the parts, and the device feels a little bit warm according to me. So let's measure temperatures. So as you can see, in the front it's 38 degrees and at the rear side it's 36 degrees. Even though the temperatures are not that high, device feels a little warm according to me, and it was the same issue with the OnePlus 2 also. And yes, I'll be coming with dedicated camera review and gaming review as soon as possible, so stay tuned for that. And if you have not subscribed to the channel, then do hit that subscribe button down below, because many more videos on Utopia and many new smartphones which are going to launch are going to come real soon. So yeah, this is it for this video guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And yeah, thank you guys, thank you for watching.